So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm pleased to welcome around the table today three famous scientists and people involved in the swine industry. And I would start to introduce Elodie Merlot from INRA. She's in charge of looking at the piglets and the pre- and postnatal environmental factors influencing the quality of the piglets. She's working at INRA in Rennes. Peter Kappeltail from Aarhus University in Denmark, and as another part of the story, is working on the sow and particularly on how to manage the sow to get, I would say, more piglets and better piglets. And I'm pleased also to introduce Aard van Enkevoort from Denkavit, who is more in charge of the piglet feed and also very concerned by the quality of the piglets. So really welcome to all of you, and I appreciate that you spare some time to discuss before your conference this afternoon. I've got a few questions, and I would say maybe a question for all of you is how to define piglet quality at the production level or at the scientific level? Who wants to answer first on the how to define piglet quality? Could you describe, in fact, what means quality for piglets? Maybe hard first on the field.
I'd say maybe two types of markets. People who produce just the piglets until, let's say, 25 kilos. They are concerned about uniformity. Piglets without damage on ears and tails, for example. With a good vaccination schedule. Sometimes the fatting pig farmer requires certain vaccinations, like BRS, mycoplasma, circo. But they do not know exactly the age of the piglet. They're only looking at the weight for the moment. For me, honestly, I would say also the age and the uniformity in age, the same age more or less of the whole group, could be interesting. If you, because an old piglet at 25 kilo has less value than a young piglet at 25 kilos. So yeah, what is piglet quality? For a sow breeder, a uniform piglet without damage, good growth and good health. For the fatting pig farmer, he's more interested in after the period after that, that the growth is okay and that there's enough lean meat. So it's depending on who you ask. What is the value and what's the definition of good piglet quality?
And you could complement Elodie about what is the marker of the quality of the piglets. Do we know enough today to say, okay, this piglet is a future good grower or not yet?
No, not yet. We have been looking in our lab in at piglets, either at neonate piglets or later piglets at winning time. And we have been looking for biological indicators of that could be associated to a good growth or to a good health of the piglets. We have been looking at indicators describing the metabolism of the piglets, describing their immune response or their stress response. And actually, until now, we are still looking for that. I think the more the best indicators of a good piglet for the moment are very obvious indicators like the maturity at birth of the piglet, the mortality rate in the litter, and then after the weaning, the average daily gain of the animal. These finally are very simple indicators, and so far it's very difficult to find biological indicators that would be better than those ones.
Yeah, and even for the same weight, you think that when you have prolonged delivery, you might have some indicators that the piglets have been stressed and...
Maybe, I think probably it's associated with colostrum intake and so on. So either they have a really kickstart of life, or they can become in a bad circle, so say they will never really perform. They may stay alive, but clearly at a much slower pace, grow at a much slower pace. And then another thing I would say is at weaning, it's highly important that they have, where you have been dealing with age or weight, I would combine them and say a high growth rate. So that would give these two together. But even more important is that at weaning they have a high body pool of fat. So really a fat piglet at weaning
is better,
because after weaning the growth is driven by the fatness. They will mobilize fat after weaning, and actually increase the growth performance after weaning.
Yeah, but I think that's also depending on the. I mean, if the piglet is only drinking sow milk, the sow milk has, let's say, 20% dry matter with 40% fat and 30% protein. So there's more fat and protein in the milk. But the piglets that drink the most milk, the biggest piglets at weaning, theoretically they have the most fat level because of the milk. But if they were not used to creep feed, dry feed intake in the sucking phase, they have the most risk, for example, for E. coli diarrhea, streptococcus, because they are not used to digest other feed. So it's not only, let's say, focusing on fat via the sow milk, but also the creep feed. It's very important that they learn to eat. They are not born as an eater, we say, but you can make them an eater by giving the right management, the right feed. So that after weaning, directly after weaning the first day, and not 5 days after weaning, but the first day after weaning, they have to consume the right amount of feed.
Yeah. So I think one aspect of the quality that we could discuss now is that it is something that we don't talk about usually is maybe we should consider more the behavioral ability of the piglet to adapt to new situations. So at the weaning, the piglet is confronting a new group of animals, so there is a social stress. He has to learn to eat solid feed. He has to learn to drink water. So he has to learn a lot of different things. And maybe, we don't know, but maybe all the piglets are not equal with this ability to behaviorally adapt to a new situation.
And that would be a selection, or we can manage to improve their flexibility or adaptability of the piglets. Can we help them when they are under the sows to be more adaptive?
Adaptive. We see many more larger piglets, piglets in one litter. So we don't want early weaning. We want to keep the sows, the piglets at the sow, their own mother. If there are 16 piglets and 14 tits, let's say, you have to do something. So what you can do is give them quickly after birth, for example, milk replacer. We see we can reduce the mortality with 1-3% when we give that. And they have extra intake and are more vital. They drink also more sour milk then. And then you change to a creep feed, solid or porridge. But the main thing is, do all piglets eat it? We know from former studies with tracers, for example, you can see which pigs did eat or which did not eat. And some litters we know also from dengue research that litters can eat 2 kilos at 26 days per litter. But there are also litters who did not consume anything. And within a litter, there's also
some variability between the piglets and so on. So
what happens then? They go, they eat, and the farmer looks at the small pigs. They get extra attention, for example, liquid feed and extra attention.
So clearly, you all talk about we need to stimulate the feed intake of the piglets as soon as possible. When you talk about colostrum, you say
water.
The big. Sorry?
And water.
And water.
Because really, you can have some piglets who need 1 week to learn to drink really enough water after weaning. And, okay. And if you want to improve feed intake, you need to have animals that know how to drink. Because these two, water and feed intake, are very linked together.
Mm-hmm. And in the beginning, when you talk about colostrum, for instance, you say the bigger piglets are drinking more colostrum, so they get more, I would say, more growth and so on. How can we stimulate the piglet to drink colostrum? Is there any way to modify, or
no,
is something that you cannot modify?
They have to figure out themselves.
Yeah.
Most farmers are not there.
Yeah.
Most are giving birth during the evening or during the night. So they have to figure out themselves. Mm. And many piglets are even so weak if the farmer come in the morning and see that one has not got anything, so it may already be too late.
Okay.
To rescue that one.